Hello, Nithyanandam YouTube Kodandi here, and I've reached a point. I realize now that I am living closer to reality, closer to my own being, and I am more sober than I have ever been in my life. Now, I quit drinking and drugs and cannabis and tobacco, you know, years ago. And recently I even quit drinking coffee because I felt like it had too much of an effect on my mood and I wanted to have a more stable mood. But I'm also aware that I've had various other types of compulsive, addictive patterns in the past. I didn't realize how much I was using the internet and social media as another addictive, compulsive behavior. I've really had a hard time with the silence and the quiet and the aloneness and the complete lack of cell service and Wi-Fi out here. And I would drive into town and I would get, you know, all of these message notifications and notifications about comments on YouTube videos and all of these things. And I'm like, I don't have the time to keep up with all of this. You know, I'm not gonna sit here in Starbucks all day. I need to like use my time wisely to get the things done that I need to get done and make the calls I need to make and emails and things like that, and like that's it. So it took me quite a while to kind of get used to the silence of this place. And today I just drove back from Oakland. I went into Oakland yesterday, spent the night, did some errands, and I realized this morning, after being back in the noisy city of, you know, lights and bright and everything all the time, I didn't sleep last night, it was so noisy. I realized that I have been using people and relationships and internet and social media to numb myself and to distract myself from seeing my true self and dealing with my true existence and my issues. That, you know, in the past, when I was drinking or when I was using drugs or when I was out at nightclubs or whatever, it was really easy to kind of numb myself and forget my problems using those methods. But I gave up those methods, so I don't have them anymore. And, you know, I gave up coffee too. And now I've given up like everything. I have given up, like, human contact and relationships and conversation. Like, I talk to the dog, you know? Like, that's it. I talk to the donkeys. I'll talk to the deities in the temple. But they don't talk back. At least not verbally, anyway. I can't just go and sit and have a conversation with someone and forget my own problems. I can't just, you know, get onto whatever social media site and read about whatever else is happening in existence and someone else's life and the world and forget my own problems and ignore my own self. Like, I have absolutely nothing preventing me from seeing my full true self as it actually is right now. I have been trying to, like, avoid that, honestly. Like, I really wonder if I manifested all of these water problems in order to give myself something to do so that I didn't have to deal with myself. And so now I realize that, like, I don't have anything to numb myself with anymore. I don't have anything to distract myself with anymore. I don't have anything to use as some sort of avoidance mechanism. I don't have any way to destroy myself anymore. It's just me and me, and that's it. You know, as difficult as it is, honestly, as difficult as it is, I have been wanting to just be alone and be in solitude for so long. that, you know, ever since taking sannyas and having difficulty with kind of coping in the world, I really wanted to have this sort of solitude and silence to sort of deal with my spiritual self. And then I got exactly what I wanted. And it has taken, like, oh my God, what's today? Almost 7 weeks now for me to finally kind of make that breakthrough and to realize that not only did I get exactly what I wanted, but now I understand why I wanted it. That as much as I was using all of these things to avoid myself, that, you know, deep down inside, somewhere within me, I knew that that was what I needed, that I needed to face myself deeply and profoundly and truly, and without any distractions, without any barriers, without any makeup, without any, you know, anything, where I can be truly naked in front of myself. It is exactly what it is. So many emotions about finally seeing this part of myself, seeing, finally being able to see myself in this way after, you know, 38 years of all the shit of the world, that now, like, I don't have to deal with the shit of the world anymore. I have to deal with the dog. I have to deal with the fact that the water is still coming out brown. I have to deal with keeping up with my own personal spiritual routine and also doing puja for all of the temples here and all of the deities here. But that's it. Like, it's me. It's all me. It's all me. And I cannot run from myself. I cannot hide from myself because there's nothing but me here. There's nothing but me in this world. And I can't pretend that my problems are outside of me anymore. I can't go to things outside of myself to cover up for my own issues. I have to just deal with myself as the way I am. I'm gonna just do my thing, I guess. Me and the dog. So, okay. Nityananda.